Good evening, you're watching The Last Word. I'm Sanjana Chauhan. Every year, between October and November, the air quality in Delhi, the national capital, and neighbouring states deteriorates. Partly because of farmers burning the residue after harvesting paddy to clear the fields and make way for the sowing of wheat. This despite the fact that there's a ban on burning agricultural residue. However, this year the situation was relatively better in the first half of October, when the city saw more satisfactory air quality days. While the graded response action plan to curb air pollution in Delhi NCR came into force today, proactively rolling out stricter measures ranging from discouraging private vehicles on roads, entry of trucks, use of diesel generators and closing brick kilns and stone crushers, in the midst of all of this, there seems to be heavy politicking over the issue. The state governments and the centre passing the buck, claiming the other must be doing and should be doing more.
अगर इसको बंद करना है तो प्राइम मिनिस्टर को हर क्विंटल जो हमारी पैदावार है उससे एक सौ रुपए एक्स्ट्रा दो ताकि लोग फिर उसको अपनी भाई द्वारा कर सकें और उसका खर्चा निकल सके उसका लेकिन वो अभी तक गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया नहीं मानी इस बात को
देखिए ये केंद्र सरकार का पूरी तरह से फेल्योर है क्योंकि दिल्ली सरकार डायरेक्ट दूसरे राज्यों से बात करके तो इसका समाधान नहीं निकाल सकती हम निवेदन कर सकते हैं और लगातार निवेदन कर रहे हैं लगातार पत्र भी लिखे जा रहे हैं
मेरली सेंडिंग लेटर्स डोंट हेल्प एट टाइम्स यू टू टेक एडिशनल इनिशिएटिव्स आई मीन व्हाट इज हार्म इफ ही गोज एंड मीट द सीएम इन चंडीगढ़ एंड मेक हिम रिक्वेस्ट देयर एंड से दैट आई हैव कम हियर ओनली फॉर दिस ऑब्जेक्टिव
So is the incessant blame game and politics over pollution choking your right to clean air? Let's quickly introduce the panel this evening. I have Sanchaita Gajapati, spokesperson of the BJP, Dr. Ajay Kumar of the AAP joining us shortly. Jyoti Pandey Lavakare, co-founder of Care for Air Delhi. Anshu Mora, comedian. Rajat Raihanda, German Chancellor Fellow at the Alexander von Humboldt Foundation. And Abhimanyu Kohar, the National Coordinator of the Rashtriya Kisan Mahasangh. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. This is what we're actually looking at, something extremely crucial about whether politicking over pollution is actually taking away and depriving citizens of their clean air. Jyoti Pandey, in the fight, first for the credit of clean air in September in the national capital, now over dipping air quality in Delhi, are we taking away from the real issue? Because Delhi says it's stubble burning. Punjab says they're not too guilty of it, while the centre says the states just can't keep writing letters. Are we missing the point here? Should all state governments and the centre be doing more?
Absolutely, you're absolutely right there. This should be an apolitical issue that all parties should be combining. Everybody has lungs. Every single party should be joining hands. Citizens are dying. Citizens are getting sick. Maybe the effects are not showing today, tomorrow in the upper respiratory tract. Maybe you get just coughing, itching eyes. But there is an irreversible long-term impact on every organ of the human body. Starting from our lungs, strokes, heart attacks. There is a recent study that the Jayadeva Research Institute has shown that younger and younger people are getting heart attacks, which are being caused because they are being, you know, they are on the roads longer. So techies in Bangalore, auto rickshaw drivers, Aam Aadmi Party constituency, by the way, you have so many traffic policemen, younger and younger, under 40. I think they have a figure of 40% where people are dying of heart attacks. The youngest person to have a heart attack in Bangalore, which the Jayadeva Research Institute has found, is a 16-year-old. Now, these are all health issues. Why are we having parties pointing fingers to each other? These are citizens of the same country. We should all be working together. And that is not happening. With the elections coming up, the political rhetoric is going, you know, it's getting shriller and shriller. And no one actually seems to care. You know, I've been working in this area for 6 years. I don't actually see any change. Even these numbers of 25% being bandied around, we don't know where they're coming from. There is no transparency in sharing of data. This is the time of a national health emergency. I don't even understand why there are people fighting against each other. We're all on the same side.
Right. Okay. Fair point, which is exactly what I'm going to pose the question to Dr. Ajay Kumar of the AAP. Ajay, while, you know, Chief Minister Kejriwal has blamed stubble burning in the neighbouring states for the deterioration of air quality in the city, SAFAR, which is the Ministry of Earth Sciences Air Quality and Weather Forecast Service, has said that the share of biomass burning in Delhi has remained less than 10% so far. So can we continue to blame just stubble burning and other states then?
No, I don't think so. I mean, we have categorically said that. I heard one speaker just say that where are the figures coming from? You know, these are Center for Science and Environment based their data submitted by the Central Pollution Control Board. I mean, there has to be some way where you believe a data. I mean, what is this data being thrown? Then if the data is showing 25%, then there isn't a reduction of 25%. Now, the question is whether the 25% is adequate. Definitely it's not adequate. We recognize the fact it's not adequate. And it has to reduce up to, I guess if I remember the figures, it has to reduce by another 60% to come to the range which is not dangerous for health. Should it be, should this issue, should everybody be on the same side? Everybody should be on the same side. But the fact is that in its limited scope in which we could set our actions on, and there are a few things which we need to be very clear on what has happened by the government. And I'm not saying we, everything, we have done everything we could to a large extent, but there are certain challenges. But let us start with what are the good stuff. The good stuff is that because the power supply in Delhi improved significantly, you don't see the diesel generator sets running, and that's led to a huge amount of pollution. The second issue is that the East-West Expressway, which was built, has reduced the pollution to a decent extent. The third is action taken against people who are construction, during the construction, if there's dust being released, there has been 8 crores of fine being imposed. Now, has the dust come down fully? No. But these are the steps. So if you look at it, now the other step which we should have taken, well, we tried our best, was to enhance the number of CNG buses. The fact is that it has gone like a football gone on a world tour with the government of India and the lieutenant governor and all that. We finally have got a clearance for 3,000 buses. And we hopefully that would increase, reduce the number of people who are using motor vehicles or motorcycles. The last and which is clearly when we proposed free buses, which are rides for women, which will be implemented soon. And we also proposed free rides for metro, which went into a spin. It would have reduced the vehicular pollution to significant extent because then people would have stopped using two-wheelers. So those are some of the steps we have taken. Now, the burning of the stump in these places do create pollution. It's a fact of life.
The buses has been going on for 4 years.
No, right. Can I just complete my mind?
Okay, you know, Jyoti and Sanjita, I'm going to come to you first.
Can I just complete
okay, Ajay, you have to wrap up. Yeah, you have to. Let's keep it really short because I'd like to go to the other panelists as well.
Yeah, I'll wrap up. No, no, the question again is, you know, I hear, no, I also, first of all, I hear the lady say that, you know, it's been going on for 4 years.
Jyoti, I'm just going to come to you. 1 second.
Can
Ajay,
I complete,
just go ahead.
Madam? I mean, I'll be really appreciating if you let me complete, then you
okay.
can speak.
Okay, Ajay, just go ahead, yeah. really quickly.
Yeah. So the fact is, I don't know which data she keeps talking. So the fact is that the data, I'm quoting the Central Pollution Control Board data. The fact is that I'm saying that look at those steps we have taken. You may not agree with it. Have we banned the use of unclean fuel? Yes. Have the two power plants in Delhi been closed? Yes. Now, if you don't see anything good in it, I can't help it. But the fact is that these things have happened. Should we do much more? Yes, we should do much more. Should it be politicized? It should not be politicized. But the government of India can also take considerable amount of steps. And why I'm telling you, it's interesting. There is no question of talk on Gurgaon and Noida. What is the steps taken by the Haryana and UP government and
right,
Gurgaon,
okay,
Noida?
So we're going to the come to that, but that's exactly the point of this debate is to not point fingers
do
and to figure out. It is to
it?
Figure out how citizens... Residents of Delhi can actually,
exactly.
you know, breathe cleaner air. Ajay, 1 second. State governments, let me come to you really quickly. Let me come to you, Sancheta. State governments are providing 50 to 80% subsidy to farmers and cooperative societies to buy modern farm equipment for this in-situ management of paddy straw and running this massive awareness campaign against stubble burning. But the center also perhaps needs to look into the suggestions made by these farmer groups, Sancheta.
The center is always open to suggestions from everybody, including the opposition. But the first thing that I'd like to do is set one fact straight, which is that Delhi is one of the most polluted cities in the world, not just during the onset of winter, but throughout the year. We have to understand there are multiple issues which cause pollution. One of them is vehicular pollution. All multiple reports have said almost 40% of our pollution comes in from vehicular pollution. You have a significant contribution from agriculture waste and from waste from crop burning, like you correctly pointed out. You also have industrial and construction pollution. Now, I will tell you a few of the steps that the center has taken. As far as vehicular pollution is concerned, just now in the recently concluded parliament session, we've brought in an amendment into the Motor Vehicles Act. All cars will require a pollution NOC. From April, the new emission norms will be applicable. The number of expressways and highways that have been opened have increased. The number of trucks coming into Delhi has decreased by over 60,000. Not only that, we've also put a huge push towards electric vehicles and more efficient fuels for us to use. Now, I'll give you another example. In Delhi, when you talk about pollution, I would like to bring to your notice that no longer do smaller industries have to take an NOC because of an amendment brought in by Mr. Kejriwal's government. So if you're a small industry, you can flout all pollution norms, all emission norms, and nothing happens. Last year in December, it is the NGT that fined 25 crores to the Delhi government. Now, as far as stubble burning is concerned, I agree with you. That is a cause for concern. What has the Haryana government done? I can speak only about Haryana because I am a representative of the BJP and we are in power there.
Right.
Over 167 FIRs have been lodged. Yes, last year,
let me just quickly, Rajat, I'm going to come to you. I'm going to come to you as well. Sanjata, just to really quickly tell you about Haryana, although you may be a representative of the BJP, which is exactly why today Haryana has actually written to the EPCA saying that they want a relaxation of the genset ban, adding that it is too short notice for them to actually, you know, go ahead and make these amendments. So it is, I find it extremely ironical that, you know, you're talking about the Motor Vehicles Amendment, which has shown resistance from your own state governments. You're talking about all these steps that the center is taking, but the Haryana BJP themselves are resistant to actually doing something about the problem.
Please understand that when you have this kind of reform, there will be resistance both from within and outside. But the Prime Minister, the Environment Minister, the powers that be are committed to ensuring that we will all have cleaner air.
Okay.
Am I saying there will not be resistance from the transport business when you bring in emission norms. There will be.
You know, one reality needs to come out in front of the entire country, that the central government only talks about environment, only talks about climate change protection, but their actions are in no way connected to protecting the environment. In fact, have been consistently violating environmental protection standards across the board. So this thing that, you know, just talking about climate change or doing environmental concerns, talking, doing lip service is not. They are at the central government, and still they say that they don't have the power to do this. They want to pass the buck to other governments. At some point, they have to ask the central government, which has an unprecedented majority in the past, that why are they being able to effective environment?
Rajat, I'm sorry to cut you off there, but there seems to be some audio issue. We're going to fix that and come to you in just a moment. Anshu, I'm going to come to you really quickly because, you know, you are the citizen of Delhi. You know, you can give us a sense of what the Delhiite is actually feeling right now, physically and otherwise as well, because when it comes to taking credit for an extremely clean September, everybody is rushing towards it. But when it comes to actually fixing the problem, the state governments and the center can't wait to pass the buck.
Yeah, so, you know, first of all, this is the second year in a row I'm on this panel with this topic. So it seems like we haven't resolved much. But honestly, I'm going to say something which a comedian shouldn't be saying about politicians, which is that something right did happen in Delhi NCR, because it was just not September. It was also July and August with the same amount of vehicular, you know, traffic, everything going the same. I think there have been steps taken. Let's not kind of deny that the steps have been taken in Delhi. Some steps have been taken in Gurgaon for sure. But, you know, as a citizen, I can tell you this. I don't have facts and figures. I can just tell you from what I smelt. The day the crop burning started in Punjab, the day it started in Punjab and Haryana is the day we started feeling it in the air out here. And that has to be the problem, which needs to get resolved. It's surprising that the central government is sitting on it. They keep talking about Swachh Bharat. I would just request them to include air also in it and fix that once and for all. But all the facts and figures that were given around various causes of pollution, including vehicular traffic, etc. I think steps have been taken. Clear effects have been seen in Delhi NCR in the past few months. The index was actually healthy for days and weeks together. So obviously something went right. But it's the crop burning. And it's surprising that every year we discuss the same thing. And the center is not taking hard actions on that.
Right, but it is definitely a more nuanced problem than that, Abhimanyu Kohar, because are we doing enough for the farmers to wean off stubble burning? Do farmers even have an option? Because I can say with conviction, the ban isn't working in Punjab. It is the job then of the government to provide these alternatives to the farmers, right?
But why... why is...
See, dekhiye,
let me just bring in Abhimanyu. Let me just bring in Abhimanyu and then you can respond, Jyoti.
देखिए हमें दो तीन चीजें समझनी पड़ेंगी जो अभी टेरी की पिछले साल रिपोर्ट आई थी उस रिपोर्ट के अकॉर्डिंग जो किसानों की पराली जलाने से जो पोल्यूशन होता है वो सिर्फ 4% पोल्यूशन होता है उसके अलावा जो व्हीकल्स की वजह से पोल्यूशन होता है वो 25% है इंडस्ट्रीज की वजह से पोल्यूशन होता है वो 26% है और हमें यह भी समझना पड़ेगा अभी जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट द्वारा अपॉइंटेड कमेटी है उसने भी ये कहा है कि जो दिल्ली में और दिल्ली एनसीआर में टायर व रबड़ जलाने से जो पोल्यूशन हो रहा है वो मेन सोर्स है पोल्यूशन का और जो अभी गवर्नमेंट की भी एक मिनिस्ट्री की रिपोर्ट आई है कि सिर्फ 8% पोल्यूशन पराली जलाने से होता है और हमें यह भी समझना चाहिए अगर हम ये पराली जलाने का समय तो 15 से 20 दिन का होता है अक्टूबर के महीने में और नवंबर के पहले सप्ताह में तो सवाल ये उठता है कि क्या अन्य महीनों में जो साल के 12 महीने हैं क्या बाकी समय में दिल्ली में पोल्यूशन नहीं होता है क्या दिल्ली में उस समय में भी पोल्यूशन होता है लेकिन हमारे जो सरकार की जो लोग चलाते हैं सरकार को जो हमारा एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन है उसका जो एटीट्यूड है किसानों के प्रति वो बहुत नेगेटिव है और बहुत लंबे समय से हम इस बात को उठाते आ रहे हैं देखिए जो किसान कम्युनिटी मेहनत करके पूरे देश का पेट भरती है उसका उसकी वजह से 4% पोल्यूशन होता है और उसके खिलाफ FIR की जाती है और नेशनल टेलीविजन पे बैठ के पार्टियों के प्रवक्ता बड़ी गर्व से कहते हैं कि उन्होंने किसानों के खिलाफ FIR कर दी है और जो उद्योगपति सभी कानूनों की धज्जियां उड़ा के दिल्ली में 26% पॉल्यूशन कर रहे हैं उनके खिलाफ कार्रवाई करने की हिम्मत किसी भी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी में नहीं है और जो केंद्र सरकार बात कर रही है कि उन्होंने स्ट्रॉ मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम की मशीन्स दी उन्होंने हैप्पी सीडर्स की मशीन दी कितनी मशीनें ग्राउंड तक पहुंची आपने कागजों में बता दिया कि हमने 10,000 मशीनें दी ग्राउंड पे 4,000 या 5,000 मशीनें पहुंची हैं
और मैं आपको बता दूं कि पंजाब की अगर पंजाब की बात करें तो पंजाब में On the one hand, the center, the states, always when it comes to poll season, are talking about doing better for the farmers. Mm. But at the same time, yet when it comes to that time of the year, we're often looking at stubble burning as being the only cause. When actually there are a lot of host of other causes. I can name in Delhi itself, there is a problem of illegal godowns that are burning plastic waste way beyond their limits that is adding to the air pollution.
I couldn't agree with you more. I also agree with what the previous gentleman said, where he said that, is this for me or for the other AAP spokesperson? Can
right.
I Sanjita, speak and
I'm,
finish?
You can go ahead. I'm going to come to Ajoy can respond right after you.
Yeah. What I was saying is that nobody is saying that there is one single factor which is contributing to pollution. And I agree with what he said, that pollution is a year-long phenomena that we're having to deal with. The previous gentleman said that the pollution came down for the last few months. We also have to understand the geographical conditions. Delhi is also a landlocked place. And due to the weather conditions and the prolonged monsoons, we've had some amount of respite. Now, we are not blaming the farmers entirely. There are multiple reasons that have caused this. The green revolution that was started is actually where all the problems started, because in Haryana and in Punjab and in many other places, crops which are not local to the area are being grown. Now, ensuring that our farmers get access to better technology, better seeds, better styles of production is very much a priority for us. We have ensured that many of the machinery are available, but you will also have to agree with me that we're a federal country and it is not for the center to go into every state and do it. Wherever we have a BJP government, we have taken a proactive approach. You yourself have said from the reports that are available, the amount of crop burning in Haryana has come down. We are trying to wean off farmers from these crops, looking at other alternative methods of growing so that we have a sustainable agricultural growth. So nowhere am I trying to say that we pin the blame entirely on our farmers. Okay. I have said time and again, there are multiple factors that have caused it. And in Delhi, until we address the transport problem, I want to bring one fact to the table.
Okay.
As on 31st March 2019, for 4 years that the Kejriwal government was there, not a single new bus was added. They promised us 10,000 buses in 2015.
Okay.
Our fleet has come down to under 3,600.
Okay, Ajoy, really quickly, would you like to respond to that? I'm going to come to Rajat, who's been very patiently waiting, yet exasperately, you know, disapproving and nodding his head, not really agreeing with what's going on. Rajat, I'm going to come to you. Ajoy, would you like to respond to Sancheta really quickly?
No, see, whenever the Bharatiya Janata Party spokesperson speak on it, they think it's the typical touch me not. Hey, we are not accountable at all. You're in a government in Haryana, you see your pollution in Gurgaon. You're a government, you're in power in UP, you see it in Noida. So you have to also say, what is your delivery? And I'm telling you what we did in Delhi. Again, I said, has the Delhi pollution come down? Obviously, it has come down, because last year, if you look at it comparatively, it has come down by 25% for the same months. Is Delhi landlocked? If you remember, the BJP spokesperson came on TV right from Nitin Gadkari, was screaming from the rooftops that the pollution came down because of expressway. So now on the TV, they say, no, it is not data which we'll accept. But by the way, Nitin Gadkari himself was screaming from rooftop that we reduced it because of expressway. So one of them must be speaking the truth, that either they reduced it or they didn't. And if we have reduced it, then please give credit. Second issue is on industrial unit. I'm saying the Delhi government is trying its best on what is in its area of scope. They are around 1,500 industrial units. Approximately 1,400 have shifted to clean fuels. You know, liquefied natural gas. Now, those are steps we have taken. We have banned dirty fuels, like heavy oil fuels. We have tried our best in terms of trying to bring in a subsidy for the electric vehicles like those e-rickshaws. Now, is it where we should be? No. But right now, why is it in September that the air was nice, and in October, because of the winter setting in and the burning of crops, these things happen? No, we are not blaming the farmers, but these are facts of life. These are beyond our control. Get us the buses approved tomorrow. If they are bleeding for Delhi and the elections are coming, let them sanction 3,000 more buses. We will give you the credit.
Okay,
but they keep complaining.
So, Rajat, go ahead. I'm going to let Rajat respond.
And
Rajat,
we want those buses.
Yeah. Okay, Rajat, I'm going to come to you. Go ahead.
You know, I think everyone in India and every Indian citizen can accept that politics is full of hypocrisy and lies. But when it comes to the environment, the hypocrisy of all governments, and especially the government at the center, is unbelievable. I mean, we go all over the world, we talk about how great, how much we respect our environment, how what a mother nature we have, we want to protect our environment, and at home, we are constantly chomping the environment. From Mumbai to Kashmir, from Delhi to Chennai, each and every city has pollution problems. It is not a city problem, it is a nationwide problem, and amongst the politicking of all political parties, it is the citizen that always suffers. What will it take? 43.5% of Delhi's children are suffering from some or the other kind of respiratory ailment because of Delhi's air pollution problem. And this is data from the Chittaranjan National Cancer Institute. There are much more scarier numbers like this. And not only is the air, but even the water is severely polluted. What I fail to understand as a concerned Indian citizen is that why? What will it take for you governments to actually get your act together and start cooperating on this issue? What will it take, really? You keep passing a blame on like this and that, but at the end of the day, today the central government does have a very large percentage of power in this country. They override federal structures all the time when they want for politics, but somehow for environment, they want other states to take the initiative.
Right, right. Some tough questions actually being posed over there. I understand, Abhimanyu, you want to come
can
in
I,
really
can
quickly.
I please?
Yes, yeah. Jyoti, I'm going to come to you right after Abhimanyu. Sorry, I'm going to come to you right after Abhimanyu. Go ahead.
So can I please just refute?
देखिए हमें एक चीज और समझनी चाहिए कि किसान भी ये बात समझता है कि पराली जलाने से उसको भी नुकसान होता है, उसकी लैंड की फर्टिलिटी खत्म होती है, जो कुछ बैक्टीरिया होते हैं जो उसको मदद करते हैं वो बैक्टीरिया भी मर जाते हैं, लेकिन किसान की ये मजबूरी है क्योंकि अभी धान की कटाई के बाद, पैडी की कटाई के बाद उसको गेहूं की बुआई करनी होती है और उस बीच में उसके लिए सिर्फ 10 से 15 दिन का समय होता है। अगर वो टाइम पे गेहूं की बुआई नहीं करेगा तो मार्च अप्रैल में उसकी गेहूं की जो फसल होगी उसमें बहुत सारी समस्याएं उसके सामने आ जाएंगी। तो किसान मजबूरी में आके ये पराली को जलाता है, वो कोई शौक से नहीं जलाता है। और लास्ट में एक चीज इसमें ये कहना चाहूंगा, अगर हम दिल्ली की बात करें, आपके ही चैनल पे आज जब शाम को डिबेट हो रही थी उस समय भी मैंने ये मुद्दा उठाया था कि आप टीकरी कला चले जाइए, टीकरी कला में एशिया की कबाड़ की सबसे बड़ी मंडी है, सबसे बड़ा मार्केट है, वहां पे खुले आम टायर जलते हैं, रबड़ जलते हैं। मैं आपको हरियाणा में ऐसी सैकड़ों जगह दिखा दूंगा जहां पे खुले आम रबड़ और टायर जलाए जा रहे हैं और सरकार की बहुत सारी कमेटीज ने यह बात कही है कि जो एक्चुअली जो पॉल्यूशन का कॉज है वो जो खुले आम टायर और रबड़ जलाई जा रही है वो रियल कॉज है। तो सभी राज्य सरकारों को और केंद्र सरकारों को राजनीति करने की बजाय बैठना चाहिए और बैठ के किसानों को प्रोत्साहित करना चाहिए कि वो पराली को ना जलाएं और पोल्यूशन के जो अन्य रियल कारण हैं उनको किस तरीके से रोका जाए, इस पे काम किया जाना चाहिए, ना कि राजनीति करनी चाहिए।
राइट, ज्योति, डू यू वांट टू क्विकली वेन ऑन दैट? आर वी टोटली मिसिंग द बस हियर एंड बीइंग ब्लाइंडसाइडेड बाय पॉलिटिक्स दैट आर बीइंग प्लेड?
यस, एब्सोल्युटली,
गो अहेड।
नो, that is exactly what I'm trying to say. Firstly, why is it only Punjab that is apparently creating all the smoke? That is not true. Farmers are the same across all the different states. Every farmer needs to clear his fields. Why is it only the Punjab farmer who is so special that he will burn his field first, then he will buy subsidized fertilizer to put nutrients into that burnt field, then he will get subsidized happy seeders to cut the there are Menrega laborers who can be put to work in those fields to get those fields to be cleared. There are also, firstly, they are growing the wrong crop. Everybody knows this. Rice, paddy is not a Punjab crop. You need lots of standing water for that. Punjab does not have that kind of water. So no long-term solutions have been made. All this last-minute reactive band-aid solutions are never going to help. Punjab needs to change its cropping pattern. Rice was grown in Punjab when we had a famine and we needed Punjab to grow all that aid rice that we were getting. That
right.
time is over 50 years ago, 30, 40 years ago. The whole, we need to grow more dense nutrient crops. We need to grow ragi, bajra. We need to grow those crops. The crop itself, the cropping pattern is wrong, and that is not being sorted out. Obviously, the farmer has to turn his crop around. I'm sure he doesn't like, the first person to be affected is the farmer himself. Next, I just want to say the CPCB numbers that this gentleman keeps talking about, there is nowhere on any CPCB site have they said that pollution has come down 25%. In Parliament, which is the place where we get our, where the people of India get their information from, they have not said that pollution has come down 25%. He is quoting the Center for Science and Environment. That is a private think tank, a public-private funded think tank. Why are we supposed to take those numbers as the genuine numbers? Because the director of CSC is part of EPCA, and it is in their interest to show that pollution is coming down.
Right.
That itself is it's a questionable number, and that is why I'm saying, please be transparent, show us where you're getting the numbers from,
okay,
and then let's take it from there.
Okay, Rajat Raihanda, okay, let's do we need to move beyond, Rajat, do we need to
move? PUC does not even talk about, can I just say, PUC does not even measure PM2.5. PUC, if you look at your own car's PUC, it does not even measure PM2.5. It's a joke. PUC is a joke.
Okay, Jyoti, a point well taken. Rajat, we're discussing about this right now, we need to move beyond this blame game of stubble burning expensive alternatives and focus on sustainable options in our local environment. How's that to start with? You've worked closely in Delhi. You've dealt with the problem firsthand. You've been responsible about the whole GST surrounding plastic waste and use. So what would be the viable steps that Delhi citizens can start to take?
I think, of course, citizens can take a lot of steps, and citizens should also. But I think we've had this conversation multiple times where we try to tell the citizens, okay, segregate your waste, don't burn trash, pollute less, use public transportation more, try to avoid using polluting vehicles. All of this is fine. But why the citizen? Why always the burden on the citizen? Why not the burden on the industries, on the government, which are responsible for the mass pollution? Why are we electing ourselves or are we electing our representatives to take care of us? I think this country really, really needs to very strongly hold up their government accountable for what they are doing to the environment.
Okay. Really Anshu, as a Delhi citizen, do you feel burdened? Do you feel pressured with these steps that you need to take? Do you feel like the government needs to do more?
Of course. I mean, it's not about a burden of taking these small steps of, segregating waste, etc. That's okay. I mean, it'll come as a culture which will spread across. But I think, I want to make one point. Jyoti, just as an outsider, not a politician, actually came in and gave such brilliant facts and figures and kind of, if I may use the word, rubbished everything that, all the politicians were talking about right now, in the panel. It seems like there are a lot of excuses which are being made, wrong reports are being pulled out, data is being given, which is very surprising. If everybody, whether it's Punjab government, Haryana government, or, Delhi government, if they're clear about the top three things that are affecting the pollution. Forget about the list of 10, 20 and everything. Just the top three. Take action against that. List them first of all. Take action and show the citizens that you've done something. I mean, if it's rubber tires being burnt in Haryana, then just take action against that. If it's crop in Punjab, then take action against that. Not against the farmers,
Absolutely.
But provide them enough equipment to take care of it. It's just very, very surprising that, every year in this discussion, there is this, blame game that happens and then we seem to move out. Just take top three in each state. Just take top three and fix it, for God's sake.
Okay. Ajoy, go ahead.
No. Sanjana.
Ajoy, go ahead.
Just one more thing. Can I just add that
Jyoti made a lot of sweet.
Jyoti, just a second. Let Ajoy respond. We'll come back to you.
You see, the first question, the first thing is what Jyoti was saying is, look, we base our information what is in the public domain. The Center of Science and Environment released saying that the Parliament, this report was released and the Central Pollution Control Board gave these figures. Now you're going to doubt everything else. It came in all the respectable magazines, in all the top newspaper and all the possible links, all the TV channels covered it. And then suddenly Jyoti says, no, but I know everything. So then why do we depend on even the national economic surveys, which are done by, brilliant think tanks and all? All data seems to be false. Every thinking person will be based on some data. Now, what is your data? Then give me the data show me the data which says that it has become worse in the past 4 months. What is the actual data of the past 4 months? So when you come on a TV channel and come with some brilliant ideas and keep saying that this is not happening, that is not happening, what are the steps can you take for pollution? And I'm telling you very clearly, the steps you can just stop the use of dirty fuels, use of public transportation, stop the coal plants in the center of the metropolis. Those are steps we took. But oh, by the way, those are not good enough. You could close, Badarpur and the Rajghat power stations had to be closed. There was this expressway which was built by the government of India or by us, but there was certain amount of reduction in vehicular traffic. The DG sets have stopped things. So those are steps which an elected government should take. Should we have 5,000 buses more? Yes, we should have 5,000 buses more. But the fact is, then give me a counter data that who took this data? Is there any other data you want to produce?
On data, I have some data.
Steps which we are taking, I said in the beginning that 25% we have reduced it. Is it? No, one second, can I complete, sir?
Go ahead,
25%
go ahead,
we took was decent. Should it be much? I mean, is not enough, sorry. Yeah, the 25% is not enough. We recognize it. We feel for it, and it's not that. But it's like my colleague before this said that India has got the most rapid deforestation happening. Is the government of India accountable? Does anybody say about the environment? The maximum amount of deforestation has happened in the recent times. The maximum. So those are issues which are also as severe. So environment is not a central policy. It is not in the minds of the you keep blaming it. The solutions cannot be a band-aid, absolutely agreed. The farmers only are not to be blamed, absolutely. But we took steps like we don't allow about 2,000 cc SUVs to be registered. You might not think it's a great stuff. We implemented from BS4 to BS6 in terms of petroleum products in the state of Delhi. Other states have not done it. So those are things we have done. And we want 5,000 buses. We want 10,000 buses, and we want free ride for women.
Ajoy, I don't think anybody is questioning any state government's intent to actually, deprive or provide their citizens the right to clean air. What we're asking over here is, why is politics being played over air pollution? Sanjayta, you want to come in really quickly? Go ahead.
Yes, I'd like to say, while he has said all these points, the AAP government has had a brute majority in Delhi with more than a 3/4 majority. What has stopped them from ensuring that we have these buses? What has stopped them from reinstating the fact that you need a pollution NOC before you can have an industry which can function? What has stopped them from using the fund that has been created constitutionally to even compensate farmers for crop burning in neighboring states? The center cannot come in and do that in Delhi. You have an AAP government, like we have a majority in the center. The AAP government has a majority in the state. Haryana has taken many steps in this direction, and farming is a long-term policy that we're looking at changing and improving and ensuring that our farmers have access to better technology. Already in Haryana, when you say no machines, I have some numbers here with me, over 20,000 machines have already been readily available. The crop burning has come down, but as far as public transportation is concerned, that comes directly under the Delhi government. As far as Delhi Jal Board is concerned, that also comes under the Delhi government. We also have looked at recent reports which have said the kind of pollution
Rajat, your point is well taken. I'm going to come to you, but let me also quickly go to Anshu, who's been waiting quite patiently. Point. Okay, one at a time. Anshu, go ahead.
Sanjana, Sanna, just a very short point, sure. And I'm not politically inclined to either party, so I'm just going to make this very, very short. When the AAP representative is talking about steps taken, he's giving us some very, very clear steps which have been taken with data. Every time I'm hearing the BJP representative talk, they're just talking about what AAP hasn't done. So it's about time that BJP should start talking about things that they have done instead of what others are not doing. Because AAP is giving us data right now on national television, and you are not. So please just talk about what you were supposed to do and have you done that or not.
Okay, Rajat, go ahead. I'm going to go to Jyoti really quickly because she's been patiently waiting as well. Rajat, really quickly, only because of your unique way of protesting during a debate. Go ahead, Rajat.
Yeah, let me just please.
As an environmentalist,
I will agree that the Aam Aadmi Party has made concerted efforts in Delhi despite obstacles being put in their way by the central government. And everyone working in the environment field knows this fact in Delhi. In India, on a larger scale, the central government has. You look at the power they have in Lok Sabha, you look at the amount of states they have. What is happening? When are we going to have good environmental standards? Or are we only going to do television shows about saving our environment and at home keep chopping off trees?
Okay, point well taken. Jyoti, go ahead.
Sanjana, just one intervention.
Okay, just a second. Ajoy, I'm going to come to you. I have to go to Jyoti right now.
We're all talking about crop stubble burning.
Right.
One point I wanted to make, we've all been talking about crop stubble burning constantly, but I don't think we are realizing that currently temperatures are dipping and wind speed is almost, you know, if you look at the data, which is what our experts have advised us, there is hardly any wind speed. So even though crops are being burnt in Punjab, it is not even that smoke that's coming over here to Delhi. So what the other gentleman was saying, it's probably the tire burning and the, because temperatures are dropping, the space heating, people are burning biomass for warmth. So the winds are going to move towards Delhi in coming days. That's when it's going to get really bad. So my point here is, and another thing that when he said, when the Aam Aadmi Party gentleman said that we have implemented BS6, I just want to call that out. That is a central government implementation that Delhi and NCR get BS6 fuel. It has got nothing to do with Aam Aadmi Party, yes. By the way. It has to go all India and they have a timeline for that. Right. So, you know, just taking credit for other people, I have nothing against Aam Aadmi Party. And in fact, I have to admit, sadly, I voted for the Aam Aadmi Party 2 times. But okay. Unfortunately, I must applaud that they are the one party that have brought environment and pollution to the fore, and other parties are now jumping in because it is becoming a political thing. All I'm saying is, please don't politicize our health.
Right.
We are
right.
all dying. People sitting in the studio, people sitting outside, we are all dying. We need to save ourselves. Please help us.
So 1 second. I'm just going to ask all my panelists to hold on because we have callers joining us on the phone line. We have Jeet joining us on the phone line. Yes, sir. Good evening. Go ahead.
Yeah, hi. I just want to make a statement. I've been watching the show for a while, and all I can really see is that the BJP spokesperson is just running down the AAP government and saying that they had a brute majority and they could have done this and they could have done that. By the same token, the BJP has a brute majority in the center. They can actually really implement all the environmental protection laws that they would like to. I don't think anybody can prevent them from really improving the environmental Absolutely. Condition of this country. But all they seem to be doing is blaming anybody else except themselves.
Sanchayita, would you like to respond to that? Because we have citizen voices over here. This is what the citizens are saying.
Yes, I heard what you said. And here I would like to say, as I said before, we are a federal country. It's not possible for us to come into each state and ensure that the policies that have been placed are actually implemented. Police also comes under each state. Now, you talked about Delhi, and the AAP gentleman correctly pointed out about the fuel changes, and the other panelists correctly pointed out that this has been done by the centre. There have been many measures that have been taken by the centre, including the changes in the Motor Vehicle Act, which have already been concluded. Also, with the number of highways, both the Eastern Peripheral Road and the Western Peripheral Road have been opened out. Over 60,000 trucks have stopped coming into Delhi. Now, another gentleman in the panel said that I've not listed out any of the things that the BJP has done. These are just a few of the things that the BJP has done. The BJP has also put a huge push for electric vehicles. We have also wanting to promote cleaner fuel. So these are all steps in that direction. Agriculture is something that we've looked at modernizing. We've ensured that alternate technology is available so that farmers do not need to resort to crop burning.
Okay, Ajoy, go ahead.
Sanjana.
Yes, you would like to respond?
So, just a correction, because I think in my excitement to respond, we were the first government to implement the BS4 to BS6 standard, the first government in April 2018. That you can't contest it because that's a fact. The second one was because it's not a BJP Congress issue, but I was piqued by the interest of the environmental friendly buses, which my BJP colleague was saying. So I Googled and found out in Bombay, the city of Mumbai, you know, they have not been able to get even 900 buses and not even a single buses out of the 900 they're planning to bring in. So the fact is that we are trying to get in, and the story of how we tried, we should have got those 5,000 buses. We accept we should have. Did the Delhi government try its best? It did. And why there is an example, because out of our 67 MLAs, by the way, Sanjana, the Delhi police has filed cases against 52 of us. I mean, they are filing. So if they are after us, even as a police force, you can imagine the situation and how difficult it is for us to get anything done. Whatever we got done was within our legislative power. The moment we got to go to anywhere else for the two approvals and all, it gets delayed.
Right, but this is exactly the point of this debate. Dr. Ajoy Kumar, this is exactly the point of the debate, is to talk about pollution, not veer. No, it is not to veer the conversation to the AAP versus the centre and whose jurisdiction the police come under. I'm sorry, every debate cannot be turned into that. Rajat, go ahead. Rajat, really quickly, go ahead.
I would like, as representatives of two
people. Okay, let me bring in Rajat.
I want to ask you a genuine question as a citizen, as a taxpayer of this country, that are you willing to work with each other for the environment? Can you speak on behalf of your political party that can you promise us that you will leave aside the politicking and you will work together for the environment? Can you say that on national television and commit to it?
The BJP is more than happy to work with everybody.
Absolutely.
How?
Absolutely. The BJP is more than ready and happy to work with all political parties.
There's no debate.
And we're happy to give the Aam Aadmi credit for any initiative that takes place.
Rajat, what were you expecting them to say?
So please approve my 5,000 buses, yeah?
I thought maybe
you have to follow when you want procurement.
No, Sanjana, since this has been said a few times, I have to...
Okay, one second. One at a time, please, Sancheta, go ahead. Sancheta, please.
Dr. Ajoy, one second.
Sancheta, let Sancheta speak. Let her have the floor, please. Sancheta, go ahead.
Just a minute. It's only fair to set the record straight. In government, when you're there, there are certain rules and regulations you have to follow. When you want to purchase something, you can't just get up one morning saying, I want to buy 5,000 buses. You have to bring out an RFP. You have to comply with the legal formalities. There is an audit that we're all subject to. It's not our personal money that you can get up and say, I want to do this. You have to follow the rules and regulations. You are in government. You can't just say, I want to do this. Please. Ensure that your file is in order and you are there to govern. Sanjana. If you're not able to do it, how did the previous chief ministers do it? We've had a Congress chief minister with Sheila Dixit Ji there. Sanjana. We've had a BJP government in the centre. How did we manage to work together? Mr. Kejriwal seems to be having a problem with everybody.
Okay. I'm just going to bring in more citizen voices. I'm going to bring in more citizen voices. One second. I'm going to bring in more citizen voices, please. We have C.S. Gupta on the phone line, joining us on the phone line from Delhi. Good evening. Thank you so much for speaking with Mirror Now. Go ahead.
Thank you so much for having me. I'm a town planner by profession, and controlling pollution is one of our regular day-to-day jobs. Allow me to mention to you that one of the prime reasons of pollution or any societal friction is also the population dynamics. You see, the more the quantum of technology that you use, whether it is transport, whether it is electronic equipment, whether it is farming techniques, the density or the quantum of technology that you use also results in pollution. And as population increases, no matter how much of control you will do, there will still be rise in certain percentage of pollution because of the population explosion. Population is one of the key factors in any city. If you compare the pollution between a smaller town, even in a village where there is a burning, the pollution levels in cities naturally go high because of high density of population.
Right.
Because in cities...
Okay. So we need, okay.
Yeah.
Mr. C.S. Gupta, thank you so much for joining us on the phone line. Another citizen voice there. Ajoy, I'm going to come to you really quickly because, you know, I'm just going to take some closing statements right now. We have to also look at the illegal go-downs. As Abhimanyu shortly there mentioned earlier, each spanning across more than 2 acres on agricultural land, because we've got Bahadurgarh in Haryana joining Asia's largest wholesale junk market in Delhi's Tikri Kalan. Now, they are burning waste that cannot be recycled. So what's the Delhi government doing to curb that?
No, absolutely. I mean, I was in a previously on a 6 p.m. show on Mirror Now in the Hindi version. And we need to do it. So I'm not saying we are doing a perfect job there. Those are things which are happening. Are there construction sites still leading to dust and not following the mandatory rules because of the dust is one of the major causes? They are there. But we would really be glad if, you know, we have a helpline number. Please inform us. We will try and we will get into action. So it's not that we are doing everything. We need to. We have done everything possible. We are the best set of people on this. But please inform us and test us by a response to your information. We will act on it. And there are lots of sites where constructions are happening, large construction, even on the metro, which are not following those dust norms which are there. Mm. But at the end of the day, the vehicular pollution, which is the maximum, has to be, Delhi has, and metros have to move to public transportation. I'm talking only pollution, not in India, in Delhi. And we need to make sure that those buses come in, the metro lines gets extended, the last mile connectivity improves. And those are steps we love to work with anybody in power. I mean,
okay. But Anshu, I'm going to come to you really quickly. As a citizen of Delhi, let's turn to the festivities now. Last year, the Supreme Court said only green crackers would be sold in the market. In fact, just days before the Dussehra, Harshvardhan launched these green crackers. But a little over 10 days to go, and these green crackers aren't available. What now? Are you seeing that perhaps Delhi is not as festive as usual? Are you noticing that as a citizen?
No, it's just leading up to Diwali. I think obviously it goes down, but just Diwali and a day before that and even a day after that, you'll see all crackers coming into play. And there is no ban of 10 p.m. which is implemented. Nothing happens really. Every year we hear these bans, but I don't think there's any police out there, kind of really executing it. And execution seems to be a huge issue here. And while I'm at it, very quickly, Sanjana, I would like to just kind of give you an idea. Why don't we get both the AAP representative and the BJP representative tomorrow back on the show and just have them talk about the three things that are still an issue, which is in their control and they can fix. Just that, not what others should be doing. It's just three things which are in their control are a big pollution issue,
right,
and they can fix. Just can we just, I mean, they have 24 hours to kind of research what those are.
Okay.
Just get them back on the show. Let the nation hear, what
so
they
I'm
really
actually
want
going to pose that question to Jyoti now. Jyoti, if we were to actually look at the top three issues that are sustainable, that can be worked on, and that are actually immediate solutions to this toxic air that comes with every winter into the national capital, what would they be?
I think the top thing would be stopping all the burning, whether it is trash burning, whether it is biomass burning, whether it is firecrackers. All this needs to be stopped when temperatures dip, because otherwise it gets caught in a toxic mass of air that we are all breathing. And I think the Aam Aadmi Party has enough power. They have enough laws that are in existence that if they just followed their own laws that are in existence, including, construction sites, I think every construction site should be forced to have, it should be mandatory to have an air pollution monitor with a large display showing what the air quality of that area is. Just simple things like this can help. Just buses getting more public transport. When you are showing this plan like an odd even plan, please show us how it is making a difference. If you're going to continue to have two-wheelers and all sorts of exemptions, how is it going to make the air quality any better? It is not. And please don't get me wrong, I am applauding the Aam Aadmi Party for, at least bringing this up as a national conversation. But instead of pulling out full-page ads in every single newspaper with my hard-earned taxpayers' money, I think if they put out numbers there that call this number if you see a fire, call this number if you see somebody bursting firecrackers which are not low emission firecrackers. I would prefer my taxpayers' money being used in advertisements like that rather than saying, here's what we did, now please vote for us again. That is not the proper way to go. These are they have enough things that they can do. Let them put out a list of things that Delhi government can do and has the mandate to do and has done, rather than taking credit for things. If you have good rains and the weather gods are smiling, Aam Aadmi Party comes and takes credit for great low pollution in September. We've had rains, we've had the nature clearing up everything, and then people saying that all this great air has been due to us. And as far as the BJP is concerned, they are not off the hook at all.
Right.
They have in fact the mandate of the country, and they should be showing the way
leading the way and being a role model. If they don't even have Swachh in their Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, they don't even have Swachh Hava. How can you have Swachh Bharat without Swachh Hava when you can't breathe in India?
Well taken, Jyoti. Excellent recommendations coming in there from as a citizen and of course an environmentalist, something that the AAP and the BJP at the centre perhaps need to be mulling over. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Air quality in northern India, particularly Delhi, is expected to deteriorate to very dangerous levels because of lower temperature and increasing burning of harvest residue in the region. But instead of a blame game, instead of back and forth, maybe we should focus on the health of this country and providing the right to clean air. Thank you so much for watching this evening.